I'm Andrea.
I'm Stacy.
And I'm the guest, Allison.
Allison, you're probably going to have to talk louder than that.
I'm Allison. Hello.
We're excited to have Allison.
Yes. Impromptu dinner and a podcast.
Impromptu dinner and a podcast. That sounds like a show that we could carry on for
If they want to watch me melt plastic on the stove and you forget about food, it would be a fantastic podcast.
Yeah.
And Allison, she forgets food too.
I dropped icing in between the crack of the counter and the stove last night, so.
The packet of icing.
Yeah, I had to make my own and it wasn't good.
It was pretty good. I ate one of those.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, what were they?
they were the apple-filled croissants, the Pillsbury ones. And then I made the icing from their website. It was milk, butter, and powdered sugar. It wasn't terrible once it was melted and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, it was like a glaze.
Yeah. I think that I undercooked really the rolls. It was good. I had one for breakfast.
You like to bake?
I try.
You succeed. You made pancakes once. I remember being over when you made blueberry pancakes.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
And she makes those
macarons.
Yes. Mm. I call them macaroons.
Yeah. You can say
those.
Either.
Those French pastries.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm surprised at how good those have come out. Mm-hmm. I like making those.
You need to go to Cafe de Mon in New Orleans.
Ooh.
They are not really known just for those. They're known for like their crepe things, but.
The powdered
what
sugar
are they
things?
Them, the baguette.
The baguettes?
They have the powdered sugar ones.
The baguettes. Yeah, they're known for those. But they also, it's a French bakery, so they make a lot of those.
If we're talking about food, I know what Allison can get me for my birthday.
In May?
Yes, because you're going to have to save up for it.
What?
You can order me banana pudding.
Oh, yeah, that's been on my list for like 2 years now.
Magnolia's.
Banana pudding. Magnolia Bakery in New York. Yes.
And then your dad can order me cats.
In New York. Cats Delicatessen.
Hmm. Yep.
I was thinking musical and I thought, ew.
Yeah, can you see me at a musical?
Not my favorite
of men dressed as cats.
Oh my gosh.
And being quiet and appropriate.
Not unless it was a comedy then.
It would be when I got done with it.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I went and voted today.
Yay.
Apparently, Republicans are not favored at my voting poll, but that's okay.
they let you vote anyway.
Yeah, they did. Allison changed her affiliation yesterday, so she couldn't vote today because, you know, they don't want anybody rigging the system on that. So she'll be a proud...
There's a chance she might be Russian.
There is. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is.
Is there?
You know,
my
guess,
origin story.
Yeah. I guess we could say she's my daughter if in case they can't tell. So you'll be a voting Democrat.
Yeah, I registered Democrat. We'll see how that goes. Just because.
For who?
I guess whoever's voted in and me, but I don't know. I'm gonna try to. I didn't feel comfortable voting this time either, or in the preliminaries. So I'm gonna try to keep a better eye on the political situation for November. Is that when voting is? November. I always think it's in like August or something.
Well, that's
election year.
Yeah,
which means. We'll all be tired of hearing it.
I'm already tired.
I am too.
So it never used to be this bad. I don't think. Maybe it did.
Well,
I think
it probably was bad for that time, but there were less streams for it to come at you.
Yeah.
You basically had radio, newspaper, and TV.
Watch TV without
yes,
hearing it.
And
you could read a book or something without hearing it.
And you would, you know, they used trains to travel and hit the town. So now it's like, every time you do anything on your phone or computer, that's what you see.
Well, when 2008, when Obama was running, I was in fourth grade, and I remember that and how big all that was, which is 12 years ago.
Yeah.
So it's weird how much it's already changed within the 12 years, like our media and information.
I'll be right back. I'm going to go look out the window to see what's aggravated the chicken.
Oh, I thought those were ducks. So
did you really?
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
Yeah, they did kind of sound like geese from the park.
So you're drinking iced coffee?
Yes.
Yeah.
For the viewers watching.
All 12 of you.
Yes.
We appreciate you.
Thank you. But would you like me to talk about iced coffee?
You can say what happened today, though.
Oh, okay. So I typically make my own iced coffee, but I didn't wake up in time, and I kind of wanted the Starbucks on campus, even though it's almost $7 for a venti, which if I'm going to get coffee, go big or go home. So I asked for vanilla iced coffee with my almond milk, or my dairy alternative, as some would like. And she made it before I paid for it, and I went to give her my card, and she was like, oh, it's on the house. And I was like, thank you. I was like, are you sure? And she said, yeah, you can have it. They seemed kind of frazzled, so I walked out before she could change her mind.
That's cool, though.
Yes.
Because those little things always perk your day, huh?
Yeah, especially from college institutions. Any free stuff you can get, I'm already paying enough.
Everything costs
so much.
It was a cat.
Oh, your cat?
No.
Oh.
One of those two orange cats that you see sitting in the front when you come
yes.
in that aren't mine.
Yes.
Yeah, it was one of the, they've learned how to get into the pen by going the other side, and they just run them ragged.
Oh, boy.
See, Lucy's gone, and this happens.
Yes. Lucy, the 9-year-old?
She was 10.
10. The last one. 10-year-old chicken. She kept the neighborhood in check.
Didn't go near her.
Nope. I feel like you should have just buried her in the coop, because I feel
stuffed
like
her. Stuffed her and just had
yeah,
her.
Just put her on top of the
coop.
Like,
crazy chicken feet.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Should have saved one of those.
Yeah, keychain.
That'd be some bad mojo.
Yeah,
right?
It would.
Coming through
we
that
should
thing.
Have saved both of those just to put on somebody's porch.
I have a feather.
Put it in the mail. Wink, wink.
Feather. Remember that feather that fell out?
Yes.
I kept it.
Oh.
It's like stuck in that little nest thing.
Yeah, because we took that as a sign that she was done when her last tail feather fell out. We were kind of like, yeah, that's going to be it. Oh, poor Lucy. Well, today, I think today just grabbed me by my ankles and drug me around. It was chaotic, but not. Nothing got done today, but everything that needed to did, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
It just took longer than it should have, and we had a few customers today, but no big orders, but they were looky-loos, which I enjoy, because you get to hear them talk and
yeah.
do whatever, but
it's fun.
Yeah, and then Gail has decided that I can sew, which is terrifying, so she's having me make a memory quilt, three of them for these people. I have one made, the top done, and today I started getting the second one prepared, which just like if it's a t-shirt, quilt, or anything, that fabric stretches, so you have to press a, like a fusible
yeah.
on the back so that it will stay in the shape that you cut it.
Yeah.
Well, I've never used one of those, and it's this big thing that you pull down and open, just like if you see them pressing your clothes at the laundromat, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's similar to that. And so I was standing up doing it, and you lay the fusible in there, and you lay the clothes on, or the piece that you're fusing, and then you lay a, I forget what they call it, but it's a piece of fabric for protection, and then you push the thing down, and it beeps at you, and you lift it up, and then you have to scoot it in. Well, I touched the metal so many times that I got blisters on not only these two knuckles. This was the last quilt. This knuckle, and then right here. And it's the kind of blisters that anytime it gets next to heat, it just starts to burn, you know. So they're healing up just in time for me to need to use that today. So I got everything fused, so
that's good.
I'll be cutting out tomorrow.
That
but
part's over anyway.
Yes.
You survived it.
I did survive it.
And
really the trick is to sit down when you use it, because it's just on a regular table. And when you're standing up, your hands go in and you just touch that. But if you sit down, you don't do it. So there's a trick to everything, literally. And
you'll get the knack for it, and you'll be doing them in your sleep.
Yes. This one is a little, you know, it's not just a standard t-shirt where you're cutting like 11, 12, or 13 inch, you know, squares and making that. Mm-hmm. These are 6.5 inch squares, and then they had like some scarves and bandanas that they want cut in every other row, every other block. And so I have to actually think. And that's
not my forte. That fabric, and you only have that
that too. Much. That's yeah, it. That's and so, if you cut something wrong and make it where you lose, you know, in a shirt, you in a woman's not a t-shirt, but like her little shirts that she had, you can only get so many rows. And so, if you miscut or something, I'm just so paranoid.
Yeah,
but it's okay. I'm doing it.
Learning thinking.
Yes,
thing,
and these people are so laid back. They just want it made, and they kind of just put stuff in three different bags, and so there's only a few things that have to be in there, so I make sure I really focus on those items. But
And those are like little kids' clothes and stuff.
No,
like
they're
that.
All the mom or grandmother, her all of her clothes.
Yeah.
So
something exciting about clothes, like the kids are getting old enough now. Like, but are you okay?
Yeah, we just made eye contact.
She was just sitting there like.
the grandkids and my nieces. I've got a niece and a nephew that are all like, you know, 7 and under.
Yes.
And it's like hand-me-down time.
Oh,
and I love it. Like the
yes.
gathering the old clothes, rewashing, pressing, like
yes.
passing on. So
we're
kind of in that
I remember
phase.
That.
I like it. I enjoy it.
Yes.
So that was always my favorite thing as a kid.
Me too. Granny, when they had their church, I say their church, but when they were pastors of a church, they would have what they called a rummage sale, which is just a garage sale. But everybody would, everybody would bring all their stuff, and it would go in this one room. And so, you know, everybody would kind of shop it before the shop, before the rummage sale itself. And so I always got like, really cool old vintage clothes back then when I was a kid that I just absolutely loved. And then all these kitschy little things, you know.
You should see what's coming back in little girls' dresses and stuff. You remember that? Not pastel because it was too bright to be pastel. That chunky plaid.
Yes.
The oranges and the yellows and the blues.
Purple?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the tiny little... The ice water blues with the tiny flowers.
Yes.
And the scalloped, like, little shoes with the eyelets punched
out.
Oh,
my goodness.
Yeah. It's all.
Easter's going to be great this year.
It was really taking me down memory lane ordering some new stuff for the kids, but it's my favorite thing to do.
Yeah.
Just buy them clothes now.
It's not my favorite thing to do. Especially for Turner.
When you get to pick them out yourself.
Yes. And they are happy to have them.
Yeah. Well, Kimber.
Just kidding.
Kimber's like, did you get me a surprise today? I was like, well, this was last week. She goes, because I want a surprise. And I go, no, but I ordered you some clothes. She goes, from where? I go, The Gap. She goes, I hate them. You haven't even seen them. She goes, they disgust me.
She's learning
I'm just
so
gonna
many
give
words.
Them to your mom.
Yeah.
She goes, I'll never wear them. It'll never happen.
Oh my god.
So she's about to get to that age where she wants a say in what she has.
Yes.
But unfortunately, the say is unicorns, and I won't do it.
Do it.
Nothing against unicorns, but
there's just so many unicorns you can look at.
Right.
So can I tell you the trick I did with my kids about when they started getting an opinion about things?
Mm-hmm.
I would pick three things out.
Yeah.
And that were acceptable for the event, and then I would let them choose from that.
That's smart.
And that was the rule.
Yeah.
And so they still felt like they got to decide.
Yeah.
And they could mix and match.
Yeah.
You know, but they got to decide, and they weren't dressed in super crazy for a wedding or church or not that I cared, but
well, you have to.
My kids had imagination. Turner would wear a cape and a cowboy hat and underwear to church if he would if I let him. So.
That's Kimber. Anything like that's dress up or costume.
Yes.
It's like that.
Which is
a
great.
Fun type of clothes.
Yeah.
She wore it anywhere.
And you don't want to squash that from them or remove that. But there are just certain times. Like, and our rule was too, you can wear whatever you want. But when I say you have to dress nice for a certain thing, don't fight me on it because we can make that a daily occurrence.
No. Yeah. What? And those fights can get brutal.
I was thinking, I remember we had to go to a wedding, and I was mad about what I had to wear, because I was wearing, like, a white skirt. And I was, like, not even 12. I was like, you don't wear white to a wedding. So stupid. I didn't have a lot of, like, skirts or dress and stuff, because I didn't like it.
Yeah.
So I didn't have anything else to wear but that at that time.
Yeah.
Awesome. I wore it. I cried.
You remember your goth or what do you, emo phase?
It's like a weird mix of both.
Yeah.
Goth but mo? Which time?
It was the, it was white trash goth mo. White trash goth mo.
Middle school?
Yeah.
Yeah, with my feathered bangs and all my bracelets and, but I was also really.
And monster tabs on your necklace. Yes,
but it was also like a weird like. I was a super good Christian girl,
yes.
So I didn't listen to the music or, like, actually get into the scene because I wasn't allowed and I didn't want to, but I liked the fashion.
What was the term for fake? Poser.
Poser.
She was a poser probably, for sure.
But it was really what I thought was acceptable to wear wasn't even in the scene at all. Like, it doesn't even make sense what I wore. Like, my first day of sixth grade, I wore super, like, $60 or $80 tennis shoes that I had to buy. And then skinny jeans and a shirt that had a Pop-Tart on it that said, it's what's inside that counts. And I will remember that forever because it stuck with me because of how disgusting it is. And I tried to do the bangs, like, all the way from, like, ear to ear.
Yeah.
And I wore, like, a ton of bracelets. Ugh.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Sixth grade was a hard year, because that was the year I started doing my own laundry, and I refused to do it. And so I didn't have any clean clothes, because I wouldn't do my own laundry. So I didn't have anything to wear, and I would wear, like, the weirdest combinations.
Who's your mom? Who would make you do your own laundry?
Man, not a good mom.
I should find a new one.
I'm trying.
There's advertisements in the paper as we speak.
Yeah, run an ad. Instagram ads.
Do you remember the personal columns that used to appear like?
Yes. Do you remember on the radio?
Tinder in print.
Yes. Yes. It was like Seeking woman 35 to 40.
That's
childless.
That single white female. You know, like all that.
Yes.
Type.
And do you remember the radio stations would host those things where you could call in and see if there was a girl there you would want to date? Or there would be one girl and all these guys would call in and just a random radio station.
Yeah, what? It was weird.
Yeah,
it got
because
weird.
There,
were there
was no
game
internet.
Shows.
Yeah. Yes. Those always creep me out.
Right?
Yeah.
That's weird.
They still creep me out when I see the things like pop up on Facebook videos of them.
Yeah, if you want to be disturbed, watch those, like, old days.
Oh, do you remember, okay, guys and girls, I guess, but I have forgot about these till I saw the video a while back. You would go to a place, and they would have a stool and, like, a wall, and you'd walk in and sit down, and you would say, hi, my name's Jack Smith, I'm 35 years old, I'm looking for a lady who likes to party.
Ew.
And then you would
I'm Becky. I do aerobics, and on the weekends I ride my horse on the beach.
Yes. And so they would, and then that person would get up and go. They would have a guy's tape and a girl's tape, and then you would get, like, you would watch, and then you would say you wanted Jack or whoever.
That's weird.
Yeah.
And it got more awkward because you would be like, Jack, if you were going to take me out for Valentine's Day, and you had to bring me a present, what would it be? Go ahead, Jack.
Well, because you look like you're a party girl.
Oh my gosh.
I think that I would just bring you me and a blanket, if you know what I mean.
It was...
Oh my gosh.
It was that bad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When was that?
You was usually
and,
after.
Yes, and there would be the guy that would be like, well, seeing that I love my mom, and I usually spend Valentine's Day with her, we would just have you come over to the house for a home-cooked meal with my mom.
Oh, my gosh. Dude.
I picked Jack.
Well. Phil, you know what you lost out on with Bob?
Yeah.
Is that he's a millionaire that drives a Corvette. But he lives with his mother. And then you would get Jack, uh-huh. who didn't even own a skateboard.
He was on parole.
Yeah.
Banned from three local bars. Yeah. It was bad. It's not an exaggeration. That's pretty much how it went.
Yeah. Poor people.
Yeah.
That's okay.
And just watch, you'll know that makeup wise, blush was a really big thing back then.
Like, you could buy stock in just the word blush. I'm just kidding.
God. To apply it, you had to suck in your cheeks,
yes.
so you get it in that right line.
Mm-hmm.
Like that.
But the people that ran those from just like a communication perspective, they knew what they were doing.
Yeah.
I wish I was in that.
I did the blush, like, not here, but I did it like here. It was like apples, it was cheeks, apples mm-hmm. of your cheeks, and kind of splitting the twos, like yeah. right there. And you would get this tiny little brush that looked like you lined, you know,
flat.
The corners. Yes. And it would draw a line. Like, if you hit it just right, you could draw a perfectly mm-hmm. straight line, and then you would have to go like this to get it to smear out. Mm-hmm. But,
really right.
yeah.
And if you're looking yeah. at the video, we're not wearing blush right now.
No, I use that darn cream on my face, so I'm glowing.
She's glistening.
Now I have a problem, but I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
I'm kind of purple.
You are purple today.
I don't know why.
I don't know either. Oh, you no. have purple flowers.
Purple flowers? Good.
Quay. Yes, and you're both wearing purple, and I'm wearing the California shirt I think I wore last time.
Here we go. How Woo! Pretty are those? Stacy arranged those. Those look nice.
They're beautiful. What do we got here?
Should we talk about them?
Yeah.
Well, really, this one right there.
Okay, this one.
It's not hen pin, it's hen bit. Is that right?
Hen bit.
I have to look. It's hen bit. Hen pin's like larger, I think. It's hen bit, but like in Oklahoma, if people don't mow their yard right away, it's one of the first flowers that pop up for all the pollinators.
Yeah.
So it's like really beneficial. And right now you'll see two types of lawns if you drive through town. And I'm not even exaggerating this. There's the short, well-trimmed lawn because they have sod mm-hmm. of Bermuda grass or something. That has been painted some hideous neon green.
Yes.
Because those people don't want weeds.
Yes.
Right?
Weed.
Or you weed. Have natural lawns, which are a variety of heights, depending on, like, the little Ooh. Things that are popping up
yes.
right now. And they don't look bad. They don't
no.
look overgrown. It's not like it's summer
no.
and, you know,
it's just the
stickers.
Things that turn green first.
And then those lawns are starting to erupt in beautiful colors. And right now, I would say, if you drive around, it's primarily purple.
Yes.
And that hen bit is what it is. And that's actually, as long as it hasn't been, you know, sprayed with pesticide, car exhaust, or whatever. So, like, if you were to collect it, like, well off a road or a traveled path, it's entirely edible, full of iron. You put them in wraps, salads, stuff like that. Which is why we picked the pansy, because same thing, entirely edible. Again, as long as it hasn't been, you know, treated. And those make not only... Like, it's like eating vitamins, basically.
Yeah.
Those plants are packed with so many, like,
one?
Phytonutrients that
okay.
they just have a natural, mild flavor. But, and then the
this
other thing
one,
blooming right
I
now is
take it
rosemary.
Out.
And rosemary is considered in this area, it's supposed to be an annual, which means it blooms once a year, it dies off, and you have to replant it if you want it. Perennials, you know, die back in the winter and then come back every year, so you don't have to replant them, you just wait for them to come up. But actually, rosemary here for us,
it's
that nice. Bush that I took that off of is about 5 years old now, so it never died.
About
it
four
stays
foot tall.
Yeah, it stays green and usable throughout the winter, but it's in a it's in a protected spot. I mean, one of these days it might get cold enough that something will zap it, but it's not stopped growing since we planted it.
So when I stripped this to mm-hmm. put it in the water, you could feel the oil, because
yeah.
it's actually an oil, and you can rip these and just put them in a bowl,
mm-hmm.
or you can just break the stem. That's very potent. Smells fantastic. And then some people will just cut them tie them up and hang them in a bathroom or in their bedroom. You can also pull all the leaves off and let it dry and make sachets, right? Mm-hmm. Sachets?
Sachets.
Sachets.
Spelled
sachet. It is spelled sachet. So, thank you.
Yeah.
To put in your drawers or whatever. Mm-hmm. So, this has a lot of uses.
And rosemary, I can't tell you anything scientific. I'd have to look it up. But I do know that rosemary and lavender often get confused quite a bit because they are very similar and they're actually from the same family. So a lot of the oil compounds are the same. Have you ever smelt one and you're trying to decide,
yes,
is it lavender or is it rosemary? But, yeah.
Put this there, in my hair.
There's some. Yes, you should. Make sure it's not bugging it.
Yeah, I don't care. It should make sure it doesn't end up. Aww.
I like it.
Is it upside down?
I don't think a flower
do they
can
have,
be upside
okay.
down.
I'll just wear that.
I know when we're in Hawaii, like, it matters which ear it's on. I think, like,
oh,
one ear you're married, one side it's like you're married, the other side you're not. I mean, it's like,
well,
I'll have
here,
to look into that. I'm not going to, like, pretend to get that right.
That's
either.
Okay.
Accurately
here,
inaccurate.
Have,
that's what we decided our tagline
is. Accurately inaccurate. I think it should be the Andrea Stacy Show, accurately inaccurate.
Yes.
Accurate.
Yes.
Say it.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Say the whole lot thing? Of truth twisted a whole lot of wrong ways.
Wrong ways. Let's do that. Let's put that on there because it's hilarious and true.
It is.
Accurately inaccurate.
Mm-hmm. Accurately inaccurate.
Yes. That's us.
Mm. Allison offered to make us a logo.
Oh, that'd be good.
Yeah, I told her it had to be just the initials.
Andrea Stacy Show.
Show.
With a peach.
With a peach. Our logo will be a peach because it's
the Ash Show.
What did you say? Wash your mouth out with soap.
This is on the internet. You can never take that back.
Uh-oh. Hope no one finds my Twitter account.
Oh, goodness. I found it once.
I blocked her.
But I had already read everything, and I can't unsee what
There's
I saw.
There's not bad stuff. Don't
I'm just
pick
kidding.
Me in that light.
I found it, and you didn't want me to know about it, so I didn't even click on
yeah,
it and
but
look
then
at it.
My brother and his girlfriend found it and followed me, so I blocked them, and then it turned into a family story.
What was it you blocked them from?
My fan Twitter account.
Oh.
For what?
BTS. Mm. K-pop.
Not to be confused with BTK. Totally different.
Except
for
in the fan fiction.
K-pop, you might want to hang yourself. I'm just she's passionate.
I know random facts about BTS that I could probably answer like a radio call-in like show. That's about the extent of my
they
knowledge.
They are for a band from South Korea.
Yes.
Part of the K-pop movement, which is Korean popular music. It's comprised of six individuals, or is there more?
Seven. BTS is seven.
There's seven. And they do music videos, stuff like that.
They were recently on
Jimmy Fallon.
Yes, and
carpool
karaoke
with James Corden.
Yeah, that was a good one. Mochi?
Mochi.
Mochi? Mochi is an ice cream.
It's a rice cake.
With
sometimes it's ice cream, sometimes it's like red bean paste. It depends.
And one of the guys gets called that because he has chubby cheeks.
Mm-hmm.
So James was saying, talking about that and calling him that.
Yeah.
And kind of making fun of him, he said, okay, Papa Mochi. So I was like, they're funny, because he called him Fat Daddy.
Yeah. Later they were talking, and he's like, Papa, I'm hungry, Papa. Just have that running through my head every day. It was funny.
Well, I have nothing. Well, I take that back. I have one daffodil that's bloomed, and I took a picture of it, but it was dark,
mm-hmm.
so it looks ominous, like the end of spring, not the beginning, so I haven't posted it, but yeah, that's the only plants I have bloomed and I moved them in front of the greenhouse into one of the little beds there, and I forgot that I did that, so it was a surprise when they came up, but I was happy to see them. Yeah. However, all of them, somehow, I think the cats have been digging in there. Mm-hmm. They're all, like, I swear there's, like, 25 in a area this big. Mm-hmm. So it'll be really pretty, and I'll have to separate it at the end of spring.
I've been so preoccupied with getting, like, the little house ready and being out there and stuff.
Yes.
By this time, usually our yard is packed full of, like, flowers all kinds of stuff. I mean,
it's like a magical little land.
My husband is at every greenhouse, like, peeking through, like, hoping they're going to be open soon so he can start gathering plants. But he has been so busy out there. For the first time, I was able to kind of, like, walk around the yard today. There's so much coming through and trying to bloom, and I'm like, I haven't forgot you.
Yeah.
So I'm really going to have to, like, kick it into gear maybe tomorrow, Thursday, try to get something done.
I did get seeds planted in the greenhouse. I'm 2 weeks behind when I normally do it because, you know, I don't get a jump on it like some other people do. I see, like, a bunch of my friends on Facebook have planted in their house already. But I'm fine with that.
It was a long winter.
Yeah.
Okay. It was a cold winter. I mean, it wasn't like the normal mild to low. Yes. It just stayed low. Yeah. So it was impossible to really get a big jump on anything.
And I reeled back. I only bought 2 new tomatoes, which are tomatoes I planted before, but I was out of seed. And then some of the packs had, like, 3 seed left in them, so I just planted them, or seeded them. It's not really planting them. So I have, like, 1 thing with 3. I seed 3 seed per pot because if one doesn't come up, you don't want to waste your time and energy on hoping one comes up. Mm-hmm. And then if I separate them, I've got 3 tomatoes if they all come up. But normally I would do, like, a whole row planter row of each variety. This time I didn't do that. I just used what I had and made sure I had the ones I wanted.
Sure.
And then I did plant an entire cell row long way of cilantro this year. So I'm going to see. Cilantro's contrary for me. It doesn't like me. But we make so much salsa in the summer that one or two plants can't grow enough to keep up with our cilantro needs. So I've planted 2 seed because they're little cells for a whole row. So I don't know. That's 12. So 24 plants. Mm-hmm. And I'll probably end up with 2. But that's okay.
All of them.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Cilantro's
good. And I planted some scorpion or seeded. I don't know why I keep saying planted. Scorpion peppers, 2 variety. And those seed, I was going to take a picture of it, and I didn't. But they, you know, like in your bell pepper, your little seed is kind of translucent on the edges, and it's soft. Mm-hmm. The scorpion pepper, if it were flat, it would be the same shape. But it's gnarled up and super hard and thick and almost sharp. It looks like a sticker that some of the things are connected on, like web in between or something. So it looks like it could hurt you already before it's even turned into that awful pepper.
That's awesome. I sent my sister for my birthday last year sent me some. Have you seen the hummingbird plant? It's like a plant that's puts on flowers that look like hummingbirds.
Yes, it's from beautiful.
Australia.
Yes.
She ordered the seeds, and it took, like, a few months, but they came in. We're going to try to plant those this summer, like, when it's good and hot.
Yeah.
So.
That'll be cool.
I'm looking forward to that, see how it works.
Yeah.
It'll be fun.
Allison, you look so happy right now.
I don't know anything about plants.
You know?
Nope.
Nothing?
Nope.
Oh. Okay. How can you not know about plants living in my house?
I didn't pay attention.
Hurts my feelings a little bit. I thought I imparted wisdom.
You did. It'll all come out, like, later in life.
Yeah, when she's 30, she'll be like, I know what seed that is. That's poisonous.
It's
this is not.
Pepper.
Yeah.
No, I'm just so glad it's turning the page. But last night, several people died in a freak tornado that hit Nashville. Terrible. I haven't really read up on it. You know, it was hitting the news this morning, and I hadn't got back to it. But I think it already had a death count, like, that morning of five or six that they knew of. I just thought, oh, not ready for that.
When you sent that to me, I kind of opened it and skimmed it, and it looked awful. And then when I got to work and opened Facebook to post some stuff, there are people that were checking in safe in Nashville, and I was like, boy, that must have been bigger than I realized by reading that article.
Was it freak? Like, they didn't have any preparation for it?
I don't know. Do they have sirens there?
A lot of places, no. You know, no, I don't think that, not like we have here. You know, nor do they get the weather servicemen or women that come in and stay all night and keep everybody up to date and stuff like that. So, but really, this time of year, a storm comes through. I suppose the conditions were right. It could happen any time. But like I said, I don't think they stay on top of that and track it. Like,
yeah, I don't think that they are knowledgeable in that either. If they see, like our guys, the minute they start to see just a little bit, they'll pay attention if they know the weather conditions are right. And I think in other parts of the country, they don't even, they just gloss over that.
Yeah.
No fault of their own. It's just an unusual occurrence.
You know, and even a tornado in Tornado Alley at this time of year, and tornadoes that come at night are
terrifying
to be messed with. But it's, like I said, it was just an unexpected, no one was really prepared, caught off guard.
To me, when there are sections of the country that don't have tornado sirens, you know, they're distinct sound, and they're sort of sound similar to if you've seen an old war movie where they set the siren off that bombs are coming. It's kind of that low wow sound. I really dedicate or committed to that.
It's got those frequencies that really travel.
Yes.
I mean, you know,
and we have one every so many blocks in Chickasha.
Yeah. The fear of being on the playground in elementary school during tests.
Well, see, okay, what they do
siren test
every day is they, it used to be at noon, I don't know what it is now, you're just so used to hearing it, but they'll test them at noon every day. So what she's saying is we would be
out on the playground after lunch or for a break or whatever, and we'd hear the test, and we knew they were tests, but we would be so caught off guard, some kids wouldn't be prepared for it and would go take, their shelter
training.
You could
on
the playground, which we didn't have to. We knew our tornado safety routine inside and what
to
do.
The tornado
drills,
and
if there's a chance of a tornado, you're told that morning, like, we know. So it was just a test, but it's still so loud, and there was one like a couple blocks away from my school, so we heard it the loudest, and it was always freaky.
And that one's just a couple blocks away from our house.
Yeah.
So it's super loud.
Yeah.
Definitely hear them.
But that's how I knew it was lunchtime.
No.
I mean, if you're out playing in the summer, you hear the... I think it goes off at 1 or 2 now. I don't think it's noon anymore.
I don't think it is.
But I can't hear it down at the shop, you know, in at work, so... Anyway, tornadoes are terrifying, and we're in that season. Not terrifying like I worry about them or actually think about them, but after you hear that one goes through, you're like, oh my goodness, how did anybody survive
even it? Even when it came, because Chickasha is in a weird, are you saying where you're from?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Where?
I've never heard of it.
Where's this place?
How do you say Chickasha?
Chickasha. We're in like a weird dip, like a valley, and so they don't go down, but they go around us. And do you remember when it came through? We happened to be out when
at Walmart.
Yeah, so we went to Walmart, and I remember the distinct air because it's hot and cold air. We felt it, and then it passed right behind us, and that was the closest I'd ever been to a tornado. It tore up one of the trailer parks on the edge of town, and they wouldn't let us leave Walmart, and there were people hysterical. And my brother and I were just like, stop crying. And my mom was like teaching us like life lessons, like how to save your battery, don't freak out, don't get mad at people.
We were in the hunting and fishing section, and so when we went through there, I grabbed a flashlight, those little dollar ones.
I think we had cookies.
I gave each one of the kids a flashlight. I grabbed a package of chips. I think they were Pringles. And, because they're yelling over the intercom for everybody to go to
and
the safe thing.
And everyone's running, which is, like, the customer service.
Yeah,
area.
And I was like, don't run. Back. I'm just picking stuff up off the shelf because I don't know how long we're going to be there. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, you stay right next to me. I had them hang onto my shirt because people were pushing and shoving.
Yeah,
and
it was a weird group of people that we happened to be stuck with,
It
too.
Was all age groups.
All ages. All,
yeah. Imagine
all price.
Everyone in Walmart being shoved into a little area. And so when we went in, they were trying to tell everybody to go to the back. And I looked at them and before we went in there, I said, you look at me and do what I say. No questions. And we walked in, and I just slipped over to the side so we could be
the first to leave.
First to leave, able to get out, and not packed in there because they were so small.
Yeah.
They get separated from me, and all hell would break
middle
loose.
Middle school, so 6 or 7 years ago.
Yeah.
But that it was a devastating tornado.
Everybody was on their phones trying to call people. People
like,
were
there
crying.
There was one girl in hysterics because she didn't really know what was going on, and there were people that were like, lucky to get in before they shut the doors and were like, we saw the tornado. I'm like, y'all chill.
it was,
I think we called dad because he worked in the city, so we were like, hey, this
the
is
phones quit working
this
for
is what's
a while.
Going on. Yeah.
But they learned that it's open season on Walmart if you're trapped in there for any reason. You get the necessities that you're gonna need to survive the next 30, 40 minutes, an hour, because I thought the power would go out.
Yeah, and you don't know if it's going to hit.
Yeah, you
and
don't.
And so maybe you can't get out for longer.
Yeah. And then you have two little kids looking at you and looking at these other adults who are freaking out, and you have to be calm even though you are fully aware of the situation.
Yeah,
because
we weren't.
Because I stood right at the door. I tried to keep my eye on the people with the walkie-talkies.
We listened. I remember
and
listening
I
to
was
them.
Like, thought, you know, like we were listening because they were saying the tornado was headed right for Walmart, and it just went right around the back of it.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh.
Which is where we were.
Yeah.
We were
in the back.
So Walmart set up the customer service area, which had the bathrooms, right?
Uh-huh.
And then that's the stock room. And then the stock room's on the back wall.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it was...
Because it went in a true circle.
It was one of those things that I just decided there wasn't anything I could do about it, and we're going to go out with dignity and flashlights and Pringles. Because, I mean, it was completely out of my control.
I remember when that one hit.
That's when that hit the church.
I didn't know, like, it was even tornado weather. My friend Leah called and said, hey, you're going to want to take shelter soon. And I was like, really? She was like, yeah. I was like, so I ran down to the karate school, and I told Dean, so he sent everybody away.
Yeah.
And then Ashley came home with him, and she was living in Watson's Trailer Park.
Oh,
and,
that's right.
She and I, you know, we took shelter and stuff. We heard the tornado, because once you hear one, you know
you
what
know
you're hearing.
Yeah,
it's like
there's no doubt.
They say it's like a train coming towards you, you know, and that's exactly what it's like.
And if it's close, the pressure that it creates and
your
the air it
pop,
sucks out.
You see weird things. You just know.
Yeah.
And then, so we got in the closet and everything, and then after it was over, she wanted to go make sure her house is okay. Well, it wasn't. She lost everything. Her neighbor lost her sister because it dropped the trailer on the sister.
Yep.
And then Wade was in pit stop. They got stuck in the bottom of that and it tore. Luckily they went into like the oil pit and it was like blowing stuff everywhere. And then it ripped the whole top off of that building and it was devastating. But yeah.
It hit the edge of an apartment complex. Mm-hmm. It hit the the apartments were here and a church was here, and it went like right through here, hit the edge of the apartment complex, part of the church. After it left the trailer park, pit stop, apartment complex, church, and then headed out.
And
then
Walmart.
And then it hit those other apartments pretty bad back there.
Yeah.
And then it turned and like went around to Walmart and then around Walmart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
my friend got hit with debris that I used to work with at Brahms. She got hit, and so her back, she has a herniated disc from it still.
That happened. I can't believe that I forgot Ashley lost her house in that.
I was just so glad she didn't go home that day.
Yeah.
Well, I was really glad Leah called. We wouldn't have
known
a dang thing.
Yeah.
I mean.
Because it just came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
weird? Okay, don't look.
It was cool, not cool, but how Mom turned it into an educational moment, because she knew something was up, but we were shopping, mm-hmm. and we went to the Dollar Tree. That was when our Dollar Tree got destroyed. It took another couple years to even get one, mm-hmm. but we were buying, I think we bought snacks there,
yeah.
and that was when I felt the changes, which is, you'll never forget feeling mm-hmm. the hot and cold air, like, literally like this, yeah. top and bottom.
Ashley was at the mall, and remember Sooner Mall, they shut it down because it wasn't just but like a couple weekends after the tornado went through Morgan.
Yes.
And then she called and said, hey, they're telling everybody to go get in the shelter. What should I do? I was like, leave.
Yeah.
Probably not the best advice, but I just thought, if it's coming through like it hits through that area, you don't want to be there. You did it.
It is what it is.
It is what it
Heidi.
Is.
Heidi. Hi, I'm Heidi. Oh. Bachelor number 2.
Heidi.
I'm out of coffee.
Heidi ho.
Yeah, I would have told Allison to leave too in that mm-hmm. situation. Well, yeah.
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 I would have freaked out. But that's when you know roads are just suggestions.
Who taught you that?
Stacy.
Roads are just yeah. suggestions.
Well, because mm-hmm.
roads are an opportunity to drive somewhere easily. That's yeah. all they
relatively
are.
Relatively safely.
Yeah, yeah, relatively safely. But if something happens, they are just suggestions.
You hit that median.
And you do what you need to do.
Well, because my dad's brother lived in Moore during the tornadoes, and his house got hit, and he went up there to
leaving work,
yeah,
and the highway was gridlocked.
So he drove all the way around,
and some of the houses from the tornado before were still being worked on mm-hmm. when this tornado came through
the second
and
tornado.
So he within was in a couple gridlock weeks. And people wouldn't move, they were just sitting there, and the radio is saying the tornado is mm-hmm. headed directly to them on this particular stretch mm-hmm. of highway. And so he, when you're in a situation like that, it's always best to travel on the outside lanes. Don't get stuck in the middle. Mm-hmm. And so he just took off down the grass. Everybody's just sitting there waiting mm-hmm. for the tornado to hit him. So he just took off down the mm-hmm. grass and went into this neighborhood. Well, there was one house there that they were working on. It was obvious nobody lived there. They were still
it was one of the only still building standing.
It. And he knocked on the door to try to get in, you know, because this tornado's coming at him. Mm-hmm. And he's beating on the door, so he went into the garage and kicked the door in to get in somewhere. And a little bit after he got in there, a vehicle pulled up and a man came in, and he said, I'm just trying to find somewhere safe. And he goes, it's fine. This is my son's house, you know.
Yeah.
And that's what he was doing. He was trying uh-huh. to find somewhere safe.
Yeah.
It was the only house left in that entire neighborhood because when they built that house, that man told his son to put the hurricane straps on his house. Mm-hmm. And I guess there's a story about him going back and forth about because it costs more. And the guy building the house was like, that's mm-hmm. stupid. It was the only house left
still
when
standing.
The first tornado mm-hmm. went through.
Yeah.
So Casey did a break and enter,
yeah.
you know.
He would have died if
yeah,
he hadn't have done
yeah.
That tornado hit Moore, a girl named Jessica, which is Leah's best friend. She was home in the addition that got hit, and her husband, he was like headed there, you know, 90 to nothing. And we were praying for her because no one had heard from her, and so we didn't know. He found her. The only thing left in their house was a tiny, it looked like an outhouse, but it was that closet she was in.
Oh.
Her and their four little weenie dogs.
Yeah. Wow.
And there was so much debris piled on it that they had to, like, move
She couldn't
debris.
Get out.
Yeah, she had, you know, I mean, I don't want to speak for her, but she truly had, like, post-traumatic.
Oh,
like,
for sure.
Stress, mm-hmm. like,
yeah.
anxiety and,
yeah.
yeah. That's scary stuff. Scary, scary stuff.
Well, I think in any situation that there's an emergency, I don't, because I've been in a couple, but You don't follow the crowd.
No.
If the you don't
you
go,
hear gunshots, don't take off running.
Yeah.
I always
don't
look for exits.
Yeah.
Things.
And I've always taught the kids to know where the exits are, and you go in one way, it does not mean you go out that way.
Yeah.
You find a different
and
exit.
If you don't know, go low.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Eliminate yourself from fields of view.
Be smart.
Which
yeah.
I always, it's a terrible mindset. Every time I go somewhere public or specifically movie theaters,
mm-hmm.
I figure out an escape plan before I get settled in.
Because
yeah, that's probably partially
know.
My fault in a few episodes.
I think it is.
Things that, but I mean, I just taught them mm-hmm. that. You know, they know where their shadow falls on the ground when they're playing hide and seek, sneaking up on somebody. If your shadow peeks out first, then you're going to get caught. So
mm-hmm.
by default, I've trained them to be ninjas.
And in high school is when a lot more,
just kidding.
We heard more about school shootings. And so there was a big discussion a couple years of high school. We've tried to figure out what to do because my school is relatively big. And we all talked about with the teachers, adults, and then our friends, how we would survive.
And my rule was, I don't care what they say, you do.
Yeah,
do
I'm not,
what's best for you
yeah,
there.
Because they don't know what's going
on. I don't
on.
Like the huddle up like little ducks in a room thing. And I mean, if you're already in the room, there are things you need to do. But if you're in the hall or on the property and not in a situation where you're locked in a room, then there are other places to go.
I have not figured out why. Like, in modern construction for schools, I feel like every classroom should have an exterior exit. I don't feel like a classroom should be a one-way in,
one-way
out.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're like, oh, if you put the exterior doors, someone can break in there. Well, they could break a window, too.
Yeah.
You know? But at least you have a way out for fire.
Right.
For a threat. For whatever reason, there should be...
Yeah.
An exterior.
And people that want to
so.
Hurt are going to figure out the layout of the school
the,
if they're that
the
serious
reason
about it.
That would be so important at Chickasha High School
mm-hmm.
is there are no windows.
And see, I don't think, for fire safety, all those, I would not
yeah,
let
there
my
are,
kid go to school.
Yeah, there are no nope. windows. There's one way in a room, one way out, and there are no
well,
windows.
Even so,
no.
during tornado drills, the whole campus is supposed to go to the activity center because it's the newest, and they have a like a basement.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I remember specifically one of my very last drills. It took over 10 minutes for everyone to get
bottleneck
down there. Mm-hmm. We didn't have any like put our hands over our heads. We just stood there, and there were people.
Yeah.
I was one of the last. There were people out by the glass doors because there's only one way in and out. No, there's only one way in and out, the basement,
uh-huh.
and there were people sticking out. So if a tornado went through, that wind is going to come through, and we're going to get shards of glass, which
yeah.
freaked me
which
out.
Which I told her not to go down.
If the tornado was already, with the drill, it
a
is
drill
what it
didn't
is.
Matter.
But it took too long. All the people walking across campus wouldn't have survived.
I remember, like, my high school had windows that went all the way to the ground, and you could raise them up, and they were, like, emergency fire exit. Like, it's
smart.
On fire, go up the window. That
yeah.
was, like, the plan they came up with.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a bad one.
I'm not so sure a few guys couldn't just push the wall down
yeah.
at Chickasha, but...
A couple of those interior walls you could, for sure.
Yeah, the interior walls will spin on some of them. Like, they're built to be movable. I think they've been changed now, maybe, but...
Mm. Yeah, the setup of the high school is weird. They have, like, U-shaped... Like, there's the wall, but then, like, the sides of the classrooms are U-shaped. So, there's, like, three classrooms in a U and then one in the middle.
Everything bottlenecks.
Yeah.
It's like, two long halls, and there's classrooms down the middle. And then, you've been there. And then, like, you
it's like
come
a
in the front
shape.
Door, and let's say you're in this hall over here. You get to the first turn to the right, and it's a U. And there's a classroom in the middle of that U, and then classrooms here. And then you walk down, there's another U
mm-hmm.
shape.
It's
and
so,
so it's, I mean, there's, it's just a, it's a design from, what, the 70s?
Yeah. You know, really, who knew there were so many things to take into consideration
yeah.
this day and age? And I get that you have to work with what you have and come up with plans according to that. But for new construction, I am hoping that they think it through a little bit.
Yeah.
Hiding is not securing safety.
No.
I don't really feel like that. It's a temporary fix.
We didn't even really get real safety drills shooter like on that. Campus. Yeah, we probably had like
get a real education.
Not really. Don't worry, we can save that for another
I'm
talk.
Teasing you. I'm
but
teasing you.
It was turn the lights out and hide under the teacher's desk.
All those basically. Things are to make you feel better. They're
all those things are what shooters already know.
Boy, yeah. This goes against my nature and everything. I don't know if I could I would have to physically talk myself into
hiding.
Just be quiet.
Yeah.
Just be quiet. Just stay here. Just be
quiet.
I
think a lot of my friends and I, our biggest thing was letting our parents know what was going on and probably saying, I love you. Because if it happened, we would either have to bum rush the person or I would have to be running to my car. But if you're in the main campus building in the middle of it, you'd have to Usain Bolt it down to whatever lot you're in.
It breaks my heart that you even have to plan and think and consider about stuff like that. It's like the kids in, like, what, the 80s that had to do drills for nuclear war. You know, my dad and I were watching Golden Girls the other night because my dad's really cool like that. One of the episodes, they kept referring to the hole in the ozone.
Oh,
do you remember
yes.
when that was, like, a thing?
I still blame Aquanet for that. The 80s.
And there was like a whole Ronald McToxic because they put Big Macs in styrofoam and something about styrofoam was going to kill the planet.
Yeah.
So everything switched to a safer alternative.
Plastic. Do you remember burning?
Fixed it.
Yeah. Do you remember burning styrofoam? It's an interesting substance when it's lit on fire.
That hole in the ozone is.
Yeah. It's sealed up because the plastic just kind of.
Siliconed it or whatever.
Yeah.
They lie to us so much. Like,
they really do.
I used to really think like there was a protective barrier around the globe that they would show you.
Yeah.
And that there was a hole in it and all our oxygen was like being sucked out into the.
And then heaven forbid you stand under the hole when the sun goes over, you just roast.
Yeah.
That's why everybody got sunburnt more.
When I was younger, I was going to be a scientist.
When I was younger, I was just going to prove scientists wrong.
Really? Scientists out there, I swear.
Doctors. Dr. Stacy Turner.
Stacy L. Turner.
Did that hurt you, Allison?
You
it
were like
it
mom.
Physically
you
hurt
it
you.
Your hands, too.
Well, we both have that same weird rough spot.
High fiving.
I got so nervous I picked a blister onto it.
Oh my goodness.
That's why it's red like that.
I think we need to get her medical card at this point because I don't know what the answer is. Seriously.
Okay.
No, she would have like paranoid.
Oh man. Oh man.
Well, I'd just be anxious that like school would drug test me for some reason.
But if you have your medical card, it doesn't matter.
Okay. I ain't paying for it.
Hey, that's $60. Or is it $60?
I think it's
$100.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe you can find a group.
I think if you're a senior citizen, it's $65, though.
Oh, my gosh.
I think it should just be free if you're a senior citizen. I mean, how much cooler could everybody be? I think you would enjoy edibles, Allison. A little brownie with a little something
edibles.
In it. Yeah, because it slow rolls into your system.
No.
So you can just let it metabolize.
Once.
Drift off to sleep.
Okay, this is on alcohol.
Blame it on the alcohol.
No, I was.
You drink?
I'm 21. I was. And not all the time. But once I was at a friend's house and it was the middle.
About a friend.
Yes. Mm-hmm. It was the middle of the night.
What's her name?
I don't have any friends. It was the middle of the night, and everyone, like, in the apartment was asleep, but I remember the door opening and, like, making eye contact with, like, this figure holding something, and the next morning I was like, did, like, someone come in and check? And they were like, no, everyone was asleep, and I stand by this, that apartment was haunted. They had other things happening, but I saw something. They were like, the door didn't open. We didn't hear anything.
Or other
I was like,
explanation. Somebody was there and then closed it quickly.
Yeah. Where were they holding?
I can't remember. It was just something weird, like, in both of their hands. It was weird, but it fit, because they had told me that there was, like, a woman that they always talked about, and it fit with what I imagined when they told me about it.
Mm, drinking and telling ghost stories.
Were built in 2012.
Yeah. The USAO ones.
We finally found a cool ghost, modern ghost, a ghost holding two things.
She didn't look modern. She was like the woman in black is what I would characterize her.
The woman standing in the shadow with two pizza boxes?
Two pizza boxes.
Where's my degree?
People do break into those apartments Where's pretty often, though.
Where's my degree?
It's that. So people that jump off the balconies.
I died from asbestos. Because they have a problem with that. Bed.
There's asbestos in the walls.
Stop. Did you know, you
Don't
know the...
lick the paint.
Stop. You know the dorms behind the cafeteria that are, Granny actually stayed in? They're, locked up, but apparently they have a problem with homeless people breaking
in. It is because they don't fix the broken windows.
There's homeless people in the apartments behind the cafeteria.
Stop.
Have marble floors in that building.
Oh, really?
You know,
it looks pretty on
by
the outside.
That circle made of stones.
Yeah.
There's a witch's coven.
No, one of my professors called it the witch's circle. She really did. Mm-hmm. She's like that, the
what
witch
else?
Area
We've
or whatever.
Called it that.
I know. I was so shocked that she actually called it that. She's been there since '98, so I guess they've been calling
Rumor
it
has
that.
It. There's also one in the parallel forest.
Rumor has it.
Has it.
Now you're one of us because you like to break out in
the song. The one night we have to put cloaks on and go down to the witch's circle and have just enough
I'd have
light.
To buy a cloak. Stacy probably already
I could just
one.
Loan you one. It may be a little short, but
it'd be too long for me.
Do you remember all the cloaks I used to make you guys and make you stand outside? I'm lying. I didn't know
oh my
that.
Gosh,
she was like
some weird memory. Cause like it'd be something you would do. Like let's walk. Let's go on a walk. A moonlit walk. Don't forget the
Ha-ma-na-ma-na.
With the dog
shaking my lavender.
Oh my god.
But seriously, we should go out there and take pictures and then. Like, make them super eerie, add a filter.
We don't need a filter.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know.
Just
okay, tell this one story, and then we probably should go because it's an hour now. Okay, tell the story on how you make it rain.
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Okay, so if you want it to rain.
Wait, no. Start, I want you to start at a specific point in time from when you were little.
I don't know how to how you want me to start it. Okay. Used to, I would want it to rain because I like the rain, and I take a water hose and spray it up in the sky, and you have to like put your thumb on it and make sure you actually spray it.
And what made you think that?
Because of Stacy. She said, if you want it to rain, you just gotta put some moisture in the air and it'll rain. That's not true.
But it did rain.
And why?
Because I knew it was fixing to rain.
The forecast.
And I would send you outside and say, Allison, you want it to rain? Yeah, I'd like it to rain. Go outside, get the water hose, and spray the water in the air, and within an hour, it'll rain.
And the last time I did it, I was 16 years old.
She believed it. She thought it was real.
I'll put it into this drought right now.
Yeah, I thought it was real.
Yeah.
All weather's predicted by groundhogs and Allison's watering hose.
And Stacy the witch.
Yeah.
You know, I always did stuff like that because I thought it was funny. Not all the time.
It's manipulative.
But, I mean, it's no different than telling you that there was a Santa Claus or an Easter Bunny in my mind. It was just fun life. I'd never believed that she would think at 16 years old you could spray water in the air and it would rain.
I just really wanted
Turner never believed it. He would be out there helping you, though. But he would be looking at me like, and she's like 3 years younger than you.
Really?
Yeah. He'd be like, let's try a bucket of water and see what happens.
I think we did. Straight up.
Don't move when you do it. If you move, it'll mess it up.
Water balloons? Super soaker.
Yeah. That's why I love you, Allison. Mm. I wonder what else I've taught you that I forgot to tell you wasn't real.
Well, this isn't a teaching, but a lot of music and TV shows I wasn't allowed to watch, I still asked for permission when I was 18.
That's
and,
true.
Like, out of the house.
I don't know why, because I didn't care what you watched at that point.
I know, it was just like, you can't watch Dirty Dancing, and I was like a junior or senior, I was like, can I watch Dirty Dancing? Like, yeah, why not? It's in the name, it's dirty.
But there was dancing.
We're Pentecostal. You
we
can
don't
only
dance.
Do that if the Holy Spirit hits you.
I never understood their like dance moves in that movie.
Dirty Dancing?
Yeah.
I know.
It wasn't that style of dancing.
No.
I don't know. He lost
I don't
me.
Either. I think my favorite meme that I've ever sent Allison was like at prom time. It was a boy and a girl like, you know, spread out mm-hmm. as far as their arms would go, and it said leave room for Jesus, and it had Jesus in between them, like a Catholic looking Jesus.
Which that's not something we had to worry about. No, it's in high school.
It just made me laugh so hard. I sent it to her for prom, like leave room for Jesus.
We did.
Beep beep. Sounds like news flash. Check to see if it's a tornado.
It's a thing. It's an advertisement to my text thing from, let's see who. Interesting. The children's place. It says, looking for dressy Easter styles for all your little peeps.
It listened to us talk.
I got a Chico's one today. Made me feel old.
Chico.
But did you sign up for it?
Yeah, I did, so I could get 20% off.
So you could... Reminisce.
Type stop. Well, do I have anything else to cover?
I typed stop and I sent it.
Nice.
To the people
I
listening.
I figure if it can listen, it can like mine.
Yeah, it can.
Yeah. Well, should I go for it?
I think so.
Adios, amigos.
Thanks for tuning in. See you later.